Hi everyone, it's Donna. Welcome back to my channel. Please be sure to subscribe and hit the thumbs up. Last night I sold this beautiful set of Murano glassware and today we're going to be packing it up. I had a request to show how I packed it up. So it's two tremendous pieces of glass. This is about, I think 14, 15 inches. I measured it. This one's about 9.5 inches. It's some pretty beautiful glassware. Some of you are afraid to ship glassware. I ship a lot of glassware and I'm gonna show you today how we're gonna pack this. So stay tuned. Welcome back to my channel. I am an estate buyer catering to resellers and collectors. My name is Donatella Bottolino. My friends call me Donna. I was born on the beautiful island of Sicily, raised in Boston, and now I live in the beautiful Palm Beaches of Florida, where some of the wealthiest people in the world live. I buy entire estates and truckloads of items for you.
So we just bought everything so Mr. and Mrs. Doll can go home. Are you happy?
We're very happy.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. This stuff is all great. We're gonna load it up and take it back to the reseller cottage.
Let's go back to the reseller cottage, pull up a chair, and let's see what I've got for you next, coming from the beautiful Palm Beaches.
Oh my gosh, I found me at the fair. Look at it, it's me, I love it. She's beautiful. Awesome, I'm so happy.
Please be sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and we will see you live.
Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is we are gonna fill this vase with newspaper because I think it will add some heaviness to it and make it a little bit more secure so it's not just really, you know, like hollow inside, and it will help it in the shipping process. So I am going to put as much newspaper in here as I can fit, and I suggest the person that bought this to remove the newspaper, fill it with water, let the newspaper get kind of shriveled up in there, absorbed with water, and then you can pull it out a lot easier than trying to pull out piece by piece. And again, I'm just going to fill it as much as I possibly can. I think I can get one more piece in there. And there you have it. Now it's filled with newspaper. The next step I'm going to take is I'm going to wrap it in tissue to protect it. So I am going to carefully bring up two or three sheets of this tissue paper. And turn it and grab two or three more sheets. So now I know that the bubble wrap won't make any marks on the vase. And we're just going to go around the vase. Secure all that tissue. And there you have it. Now it's all nicely wrapped. My next step will be to take this 1-inch bubble, and I buy my bubble wrap locally, and I'm very, very happy with the quality of it. I am gonna be trying maybe some Bubble Boy. I'm not sure. I'm very happy supporting the local place where I buy it. It is perforated, so I'm just gonna tear off a sheet there, and I'm going to make a little bit of kind of a square little pillow that I'm gonna put on the bottom of this vase. And let me get my tape gun. To secure it to the bottom. And that will act as a little pillow down there. Take that around. I did three sides, which should be enough. Okay, now I'm going to take three lengths and I'm going to fold it in half. Now, here's a little tip that I learned from my friend Don, who does a lot of packing for people that move from one house to another. She always says, don't use the bubbly side towards the item. Always use the smooth side, because sometimes the bubbly side can leave impressions. I have mine wrapped in tissue, so that's not going to be a case. But if you're just using bubble wrap straight up on an item, always use the smooth side. So now we've got this little bit of a cushion here and some of my DNA. We'll get rid of that because I don't need my DNA. And I'm going to go around the base of the vase. As it's folded. So that is doubled up. Okay. And I'm going to take another square. And I am going to put the other square at the top. And secure it that way. Okay. Now I'm going to take another double wrap. I'm going to take this and fold it in half. Put this. It didn't quite reach this spot here, so I'm going to get another piece. And just continue my way. Okay. Oops. So far, so good. I'm going to take some more bubble wrap. And I am going to go around the whole entire vase. This way. And one more time around. This way. Okay. So far, so good. Okay, so next I have this mattress topper gel foam box that I'm going to repurpose. As you can see, this is 2-ply, so it's nice and strong. And I'm always looking for these nice strong boxes from my neighbors. I'm all about recycling and using materials that aren't just going to go into the waste. So let me show you how I'm going to repurpose this box. First thing we're going to do is hope that it fits in snugly into this box, which I think it will. And there we have it. It fits perfectly down in there. So now I want to make this box smaller because it's too big for the item. I use a bread knife. This is my best cutting tool that I have. I used to use a box opener when I would trim down my boxes, but I find that a bread knife works the best for me. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slice it down in the corners evenly. Just to where I think, and then I'm gonna look at it and make sure that it's sliced down. You want it to be as pretty even as possible. I'm gonna get rid of this flap. And I save these flaps, especially these strong ones, when I'm doing ephemera. They come in very handy, so I have an area that I keep them in my shipping room. Okay, so the next step is we're gonna fold down these two flaps. Get it as tight as possible so there's no movement. And we're gonna tape that down. Next, I'm gonna bring in this flap, which doesn't, it's a little bit too big. Bring that down, and then we're gonna bring this one down, okay? And we're gonna tape that. Don't be bashful on the tape. Nice and tight. So that is the vase, and this box is actually gonna be going into another box. So now let's do the dish. Okay, so now here is the beautiful matching dish to the vase. Absolutely gorgeous. And we're gonna do the same process here in the middle, where we're gonna put some newspaper. But first, I am going to put some tissue in it. Protect it, and then I'm going to just stuff the middle of it and tuck in some of the tissue and bring up some more tissue here. And that and around this side, and right now we're just protecting the glass from being touched by the bubble wrap. I don't want the bubble wrap touching the glass. I'll just add a couple more pieces just to make it look clean. Tip this upside down. Okay. One more piece of tape should do it. Okay. So if you remember, this dish had a beautiful lace pattern going all the way around it. And I want to try to protect that as much as possible. So I have a pool noodle. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to see roughly, well, it's just about the whole noodle. I'm only going to cut off maybe 5 inches of the noodle. And then I'm going to use my knife. And I'm going to slice it halfway. I'm not going all the way through, just going halfway. Okay? And there you have it. And I'm going to open this up a little bit. And I am going to wrap this completely around the beautiful lace. Just going to work it all the way around. It's a little bit difficult, but I always say if it was easy, everybody would do it, right? Let's see here. I hope the camera angle is good. All right, and I'm gonna cut this off. That right down in there. And tape that on. So what do you think so far? Pretty good, right? Okay, now we have these voids here. I'm gonna take my pieces that I cut off. And I'm going to put one there, and one there. And here, and here. Okay. Now, I'm going to take my bubble wrap. And I'm going to lay that on there. Pick up the dish and flip it. And make sure those are all in place. I'm going to tape that. Another piece of bubble wrap. And I'm gonna go this way with that. And I'm gonna take now I'm gonna go find a box that this will fit into comfortably. And here I found it's a dog food box. It's 1-ply, but it's a very, very thick 1-ply. So we're gonna use this box for the dish. Okay, so that is a perfect snug fit. Fits perfectly, but we have a lot of room on this side. And of course we have a lot of room that needs to be trimmed off here. So let me show you how I do that. And the first thing I'm going to do is cut this side of the box. And I'm going to cut it, if you can see, I'm going to cut it all the way down and this side as well. And I'm going to cut that all the way down as well. And I'm going to just remove I'm going to remove this entire flap. Okay, so that's one whole side of the box is gone. As you can see, I removed the entire side flap of this box. Then I'm going to cut it to just where the dish is. Don't forget, guys, this is really, really thick. These are your dog food boxes, so the ply on it is very, very thick. I hope my camera's at a good angle, because I'm not looking at the camera, I'm doing my work. Okay, then I'm gonna fold this up. See how I just folded it up? There's no scoring needed. And then I'm gonna take this flap, let me see if I can turn this so that you can see, and I'm going to make sure the flap is up, and I'm gonna bring this in. And I'm going to tape it as soon as I find my tape gun. I'm going to, whoops, don't you love it when your tape gun does that? Okay, we got to let go of that, fix it. All right, fold that up, cooperate tape. Nope, it's not cooperating. All right, let's start fresh. I'm going to tape this up. Give that a nice, good, secure bond. And now we're going to do the same on this side, where I'm going to just bend this in. Make sure that this flap is up so it bends with it. Give it a little bit of a crease. And then I'm going to take it and tape that. Again, don't be afraid of using lots of tape. Make sure the tape is all secure there. Now, you've got these two pieces here. Make sure they're nice and squared off. And you are going to cut this down. You want to cut it all the way down to where the dish is. And you're going to do the same on this side. Cut it all the way down to where the dish is. Now I'm going to push these flaps down. And we need to cut this side to where the dish is. Side to where the dish is. And I've got a couple of areas here that probably it won't move because it's a nice snug hole, but I am going to fill it with some newspaper just to make sure there is no moving space at all. Okay, now I'm gonna put these flaps down and I'm gonna put this flap down and then I'm gonna bring this flap over and this flap over. And how do you like that? Okay, now that the flaps are down, we are just gonna go at it with the tape. Again, lots and lots of tape. Hold it all together, hold it all down. And then I like to go around, all the way around the side, with lots more tape. And that, my friends, is not gonna go anywhere. It's nice and secure in there. Now these two boxes will be going in another. These two boxes will be going in another box, and they're gonna be going in a big two-ply box. Which is right here. This is another very big box. This person purchased several things, so they'll be shipping out. There's something all over this box, but I think it's okay. I will be shipping out other things to this person. So probably we'll be shipping out two of these boxes. I'm in South Florida. We're gonna put a little bit of bubble on the bottom of that just for extra protection. A little bit more here on the bottom. And this hopefully will fit perfectly in there. It does. And let me see if there's enough room to put even one sheet. There isn't. We'll put it over here on this side. Put it there. And this box will get filled up with some other stuff, and then the smaller box will go in a similar box, and I'm either gonna stack them, because I have two boxes this size, or I'm gonna send them individually. I'm gonna check the shipping and see where they're going and see what the best economical way to ship it. It probably will be UPS, and I'm guessing it's gonna be between $35 and $40 per box to ship this out. So, okay guys, thanks for watching. I'm sorry I wasn't on camera. I am a hot mess. I'm trying to get all my orders out. Please give this video a thumbs up. I hope that you learned something from it, and we will see you live. Thank you.